हेलो सो हाई गाइज, गुड मॉर्निंग एंड सॉरी आई वॉज लेट बाई 2 मिनट्स. या सो वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग विद द स्ट्रिंग्स पार्ट. आई होप आई एम ओ या आई होप आई एम ऑडिबल नाउ गाइज. ओके, सो वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग विद द स्ट्रिंग्स पार्ट. सो अगेन वी आर जस्ट लुकिंग एट द इनबिल्ट फंक्शंस, बट रिमेंबर समहाउ वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड द लॉजिक ऑल्सो, वॉट गोज बिहाइंड द सीन्स. Right, so let us see a function to copy from one string to another string. So remember this, this is a new command that I'm introducing. This is, let me just zoom in this. Okay, this is a system CLS, right? So basically, this is nothing but basically executing the CLS command, that is a clear screen command on the terminal. So basically, what happens here is that. So let's say you have all this stuff written here, right? So let me just comment this out and let me execute the code. So you can see all this stuff actually comes here and then our code executes and then this is the output. So when I execute this system CLS command, what it will be, it will actually clear the screen before execution. So now you can see you just get your executed program right here. If you are working on a Mac or a Linux system, you just make this as clear. Right, because in Windows, in Mac and Linux, it is CLEAR, clear. Right, so I am using Windows, I am using CLS. So right now we have a string array. We have a string array 1 having 20 length and which is having C programming, and we have string array 2, right, which is just defined as 20 and it's not initialized. So now I'm using the function string copy and just see the observation here: string 2 comma string 1. Right, so let me just get to the board. So we have str of 1. I don't know. So we have STR1, which is of 20, and that is C programming. And str of 2, which is not initialized to anything. And if you see the function, what it does is like string copy str cpy, right? So str is a string and cpy is the copy. So just shorthand copy to cpy. And we are writing string 2 to string 1. Str cpy. So in most of the string programs, remember one thing is like, so what basically this command does is it copies from the right to left, right? So string 1 gets copied to string 2. So it is not the other way around. String 2 will not get a copy into string 1, right? So this is not allowed. From the right to the left. It is just like, you know, when you write x is equal to x plus 5, this thing is computed first and then this goes on to the left hand side. Similarly here, string 1 had C programming and C programming gets copied into string 2. So that is what string copy actually does. Now let us see the output of this code. I mean, it's a very simple code. Puts is nothing but you can just do a printf percentage s also. So you can see when I'm doing string 2 basically gets C programming. Now see, inbuilt functions are okay. They are like black boxes, right? So we need to understand how actually it works in real time. So in real time, what happens? So for example, I will just take a small string. So just to show you the concept, let's say str1 is hello. And str2 is defined nothing, right? So what happened, as I said, whenever you declare a string, hello, you will have something slash zero at the end, right? And let me just box them out because a character occupies 1 byte in the memory. For every 1 byte, this is the memory location. So when you do strcpy, so what it does internally, it runs a for loop starting the base address. See, it's a string, right? So str1 basically contains the address to the character h, right? Let's say this address is 2000. So I keep on copying this to str2, then I copy hello, then I copy l, then I copy l, then I copy o, and then finally I copy slash 0. Now that I know that slash 0 is representing the end of the string, so I know that, okay, the end of the string has been reached and I get a copy of the entire string, right? So just a simple concept. So now the program 7 is the same function, but with a variable n here. So you can see this function is strncpy, right? So if I remove the n, it becomes strcpy. So strncpy says that we want to copy only n characters, right? So let's say you have hello. Okay, let us just see the code for this. I have a character x, happy birthday to you. And I'm defining two character arrays, size 1 and size 2. Size 1 I'm defining 25 and size 2 I'm defining 15. Fine. So see here, I'm doing strcpy, right? I'm just doing strcpy. So what will happen? String in x, that means happy birthday to you, will actually be copied to y, right? So basically this string will also contain happy birthday to you. Let us just execute the code. So see, the string in x is happy birthday to you. Of course it was initialized to this part only. Then string in y is happy birthday to you. Why? Because we did strcpy. And now just see what we are doing. We are doing strncpy, right? This n is extra here. N means I want to copy some fixed amount of characters only. So what is the fixed amount of characters? So basically x will be copied to z, right? So x is this. So happy birthday to you will be copied to z, right? And what is the size? Size 2 minus 1. What was size 2? Size 2 was 15. So 15 minus 1 is 14. Right, so that means copy 14 characters of x into z. So now let us see how it will function. So let us pen color is black. Right, so we have right at above I am writing memory representation that begins from 0, first byte, second byte, third byte, fourth byte. This basically is the space character 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 13 is birthday. 14 is again the space character, right? 15 16 17 is again the space character, 18, 19, and 20. Right? So this string is of length 20 characters. In the last, it will be slash 0 as always. Just let me quickly show you. And now, so what was my command? My command was str ncpy, right? This n is here. So I am saying this was my string x, string is an array. And I am saying size, I think it was size 2 minus 1, which implies, what was size 2? Size 2 is 15. So this implies str ncpy z x 15 minus 1 is 14, right? So first 14 bytes will be copied. So what are the first 14 bytes? So if I write from 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. See, the 14th byte basically ends at birthday. Why? Right? So when I do this x, so basically x is a string having the complete happy birthday to you. And when you copy only the first 14 bytes to z, you are actually copying the first 14 bytes. That means you are copying till happy birthday, right? And that is what you are getting here. You can see the string in z is happy birthday, right? So let us do one thing. Now let us try and see what it is doing when the copying is done. It basically terminates the string using slash 0, right? So that, you know, the compiler actually knows till when to, you know, terminate the string. So this again is very important. Now you may get confused that, okay, when we did the copying of this, we used size minus 1, right? So basically these were first 14 bytes. And size minus 1 is basically the 14th location. That means the 15th... So basically when I do size minus 1, this is 14, right? So basically this is 14 of this particular thing. But in terms of memory representation, that 14 is nothing but the memory location 15, right? So basically this will be the space. So basically this space basically will be replaced by slash 0 in string 2, right? So ending in slash 0 is necessary because then the compiler comes to actually know, okay, what is the end of the string? Fine. So these are very standard programs. You can just execute on your side and then just try to see what is the output. Right? Again, string concatenation. Right? So I have two string, happy and new year. Right? And there is a function called strcat. Right? Strcat basically is string concatenation. Concatenation, basically the meaning of concatenation is joining. Right? So basically what we are doing, we are joining string 1 and string 2. Basically string 2 will be appended to the string 1. So what was string 1? So let me just come back to the board. So string 1 was happy. And string 2 is new year. So when I do str cat, cat means concatenate. Concatenate means join. So I am writing S1 to S2. Again, it goes from right to left. That means content of S2 will be appended to the end of string 1. So what was string 2? It was happy. And what is string 2? Is new year. So just let us see what happens here. So you can see there is a small space here, right? After happy, there is a small space here. So I'm highlighting that. So when the output will be coming in a proper format, Happy New Year. And similarly to string cat, we also have a str n cat. N means to copy selected characters only, right? So now let us see the output. Okay, instead of 6, let me just keep it 8 so that it is visible. So you can see happy contains 5 characters. Then we have a space in happy. This is the 6th character. And then for the string 2, in order to incorporate 8 characters, I have to include only 2 characters from string 2. That is NE. Fine. So again, string cat S3, S1. Basically, because my previous string was happy any, right? And so this basically comes at S3 comma S1. So what was S3 in our previous case? S3 in our previous case was happy any. And what was S1? S1 basically, if you see in this particular example, when we did the string cat S1 comma S2, this string got concatenated and got saved into S1. Okay, let me just show you what happens. So remember, with this string functions, when you do a string cat S1 comma S2, S2 gets copied to S1 and the value of S1 is overwritten. So basically, let's say S1 was hello and let's say S2 was hi. Fine. So when you do string cat S1 comma S2, so now what will be the case? S1 basically will be concatenated, right? It will join with S2. So now S1 will be becoming hello, hi, and S2 will be remaining hi only, right? So remember that original value of S1 is then lost, right? So you may be feeling that, okay, we are not initializing anything, but basically this is how the function works. So all string functions, basically they will do the manipulation and then override the value that was previously stored in this, right? So in general, we have a string function. We call this as destination and this is source. So you pick the source and do an operation on the destination depending on the function. So in most of the cases, it remains the same, right? Similarly, we have string comparison, right? So how do string comparison takes place? So you can see these are strcmp, right? For compare, they use a shorthand comparison, right? Const char, basically why? See, the const is placed on character. So that means no part of my program can modify these strings, right? All the three strings are constant. So let me just run the code. Again, for those who are watching, systemcls is just to clear the screen. If you are using Mac or Linux, use clear command, C-L-E-A-R, right? So you have three string, S1, S2, S3. And see what I'm doing, string compare S1 and S2. So now if you see Happy New Year and Happy New Year are exactly same string, right? So it returns 0, right? So basically the string compare function returns 0 if the strings are equal, else it returns a non-zero value. Now let us see what happens when you have a string compare S1 and S3. So what was S1? S1 is Happy New Year, S3 is Happy Holidays, right? So now what happens here? See, the function is now returning 1 to you, fine? And similarly, in the third case, if we are comparing S3 with S1, so basically we are comparing Happy Holidays to Happy New Year, it's returning -1. Right, now I will explain you how this string comparison actually works. Fine. So internally, when you are comparing strings, see, you have already studied ASCII values. So I'm just showing you a small ASCII table. Right. So see, capital A begins from integer 65, right, in terms of ASCII representation. And similarly, small a begins with the character representation 97. Right. So now let us see how the string comparison actually works. So first is okay, whenever two strings are exactly equal, they are basically returning 0. The function returns 0, implying that both the strings are same. Now let us compare Happy New Year with Happy Holidays. Fine. So if you can see here, so let me just go to the blackboard, Happy New Year and Happy Holidays. So let me just separate this out. Right. So we may not require to go beyond this. So now let me just come to the ASCII table of this. Right. How the internal logic works. See, string comparison can tell you it is equal or not equal, but we should understand that there is some code written in strcmp also. Right. So now see, when you compare h with an h, internally what happens? The ASCII value of h is compared with the ASCII value of h. So what happens? The ASCII value of capital H is 72. So that means internally what happens? 72 is compared with 72, right? So 72 is equal to 72. So all good. Then what happens? We are comparing APPY. We are comparing ASCII value of small a, which is 97, with 97. Then we are comparing ASCII value of, okay, so this table has done something wrong here. Okay, this is 112 actually. Small p is 112. So small p is 112. Again, small p is 112. And now y. Small y is 121. This is 121. This is 121. Space again, space is compared. Then we are actually getting a difference here. See, n is compared to h. Now what is n? Capital N basically is 78. Right? And capital H basically is 72. Right? So now what is the difference between these two? See, the difference between these two is 6. Right? So that means 78 and 72, the difference is 6. So the moment the difference gets to 0, the gets to non-zero value, right? See, all the differences here, 72 minus 72 is 0. 97 minus 97 is 0. Everything comes out to be 0. That means till that point, the strings are actually equal. Now, when we are coming 78 to 72, now we need to observe the function what we were doing. Right? So we are comparing string 1 with string 3, S1 and S3. Right? So when we are doing string compare S1 and S3, we are comparing these two guys, right? So at a particular point, this will become 78 minus 72, right? Because this was the first difference, right? And what we do in string, we take from the right hand side to the left hand side. So basically 78 minus 72, which is equal to 6. Guys, so my compiler is basically GCC 6.0. Let me just show you in an online compiler. This actually, the newer compiler will return 6 here. So let me just try to check in the online mode. Fine. So let me now run the code. So you can see string comparison S1 and S3 is giving you 6, right? The logic here is that whenever you are doing string comparison, it will do a, so you need to keep this table in mind, right? And it will basically do a ASCII comparison, right? So for example, if you want to take a very simple example, so let us keep this string as A. And this as S3 as Z, right? And let us keep this as something called K, fine? Right? Now let me execute. So when I compare S1 and S2, right? So you can see I am getting S1 and S2 as minus 10 and S1 and S3 as minus 25, right? So S1, A and Z, right? A and Z I'm getting as minus 25. Obviously, because the difference between A and Z is minus 25. Now, how does minus 25 come? Is through this. Let me just open VS Code. See, A is 65 and Z is 90. Right, so when you compare 65 and 90, 65 minus 90 is minus 25. And that is why you are getting this particular difference. Now what is happening for the next case, it was K, right? We are doing S1 and S2. So what is the difference? Minus 10. So let us see between A and K. So A is 65 and K is 75. 65 minus 75 is minus 10, right? So this is how basically the string manipulation actually works, right? So this was just the concept on how we manipulate on string. And so basically, if you can see in the older compilers, it is coming as zero and non-zero, right? The logic is same. If the string is equal, it is zero. If the string is not equal, it is minus one. Again, we have a program called as string compare with the n characters, right? You can see str and cmp. So in this, basically what happens is we are comparing only n characters. So you can see I'm comparing only six characters, first seven characters, that's it. Right. So when I run this program, so you can see the output is actually the same, but in this case, the compiler is actually showing you the ASCII difference, which should have been here also, but the compiler, this my compiler is GCC 6.3. Right. I am not sure whether GCC minus V will give me. Yeah. See, GCC minus V is GCC version. So you can see this is GCC 6.3, or you can see this particular version. From GCC 7 and above, I see that even strcmp will give you as 6 and minus 6. Right? So guys, we can take a small break for 5 minutes and we return at 11 o'clock.
Sir.
Yeah, doubts and queries are welcome by the time. Others can have a break.
Sir, when we are copying the string from one to another, so before this, in a previous class you mentioned, like suppose if you are copying the content from string 2 to string 1, and suppose we and we write str1 is equal to str2 not equal to null, till then we have to copy it. But in this process, like with that slash 0, we copied already before checking whether it is null or not.
Okay, so can you tell me which program are you referring today? String 8 or this one? This one?
I think you were talking about the, no sir, I was talking about the pointer based program which you gave for string.
Okay.
In the previous class actually.
In the previous class. Okay, let me, so June 7th. Okay, June 3rd. Then I will have to open all the codes. Just a minute. File, open folder. So this becomes June 3. Okay. String 0. You can see the screen, right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Sir, so in this... S1 of I equal to S2 of I not equal to slash 0. By the time slash 0 comes, like this will get copied.
Correct.
And then only checks.
No. It's not like that. See, for example, this was a copy function, right? So, see, I will just explain you how this works. So, let's say we have a string. Okay, let me just check what we did here. We had a string size, we had a string to hello, and then in the copy one function, we were passing both the string. They get copied as S1 and S2. Okay, fine. Let me just explain the code. Next. Okay, so I'm just keeping a shorthand here. So S. Just a minute. We have string 2 as hello. And okay, fine. we have S1 is equal to, what is the size here? Whatever, let's say the size is, S1 size is 10. And S2 is hello, fine. And now let us come back to the function. So basically your doubt is in this particular section, right? How is it working?
Yes, sir. Only the last argument. I mean, by the time that when that statement S1 of I is equal to S2 of I, but in the situation where S2 of I is now less 0, it will get copied into S1 and then checks for null character, slash 0 in S2, isn't it?
No, this is how not it works. I hope I get your point. Let me just show you how this particular for loop actually works. So let me show you for int I is equal to 0, S1 of 1 of I is equal to S2 of I. Okay, so what we are doing here is like we are beginning from I is equal to 0 and we are saying that S1 of I is equal to S2 of I. So let me now just do for S2, let me write hello like this a bit spaciously, right? And I is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, right? And let me change the pen color to this one. This is slash 0 and this is the fifth string, right? And S1 is basically all blanks, right? So S1 is nothing, right? It's just blank. So now see what I'm doing here for int I is equal to 0. So what I'm saying, S1 of 0 is equal to S2 of 0. So what will happen? So let me again pen color to blue. So when I is 0, that means I say S1 of 0 is equal to S2 of 0, right? And since it is a bracketed thing, so this has a higher preference. And we know that the initializations or the assignments takes from right to left. So what is S2 of 0? S2 of 0 is H, right? So this value is H, which goes into S1 of 0, right? So basically, the output of this bracket is nothing but H basically, fine. So S1 of this will become H. Now I am comparing whether H is not equal to slash 0. So H is not equal to slash 0, right? Which is true, right? Because H is not equal to slash 0. That means I will execute the for loop once again. Not what I will do, I will do I plus plus. Now I becomes 1, right? So what will happen in this particular loop? S1 of 1 will be equal to S2 of 1, right? Again, assignment is from right to left. So what is S2 of 1? It is E. So E will get assigned to S1 of 1. So this becomes now E, right? So the output of the bracket is E. So E is not equal to slash 0, which is again true, right? E is not equal to slash 0. So then again I do I plus plus, right? So this will keep on continuing. So basically we will get L, and now see what happens on this particular loop, right? When I is equal to 4. When I becomes 4, we have S1 of 4 is equal to S2 of 4, right? Assignment is from right to left. So S2 of 4 is basically O. O gets assigned to here, right? So basically O is not equal to slash 0, which is again true. So we go to I plus plus. So I becomes 5, right? So now what happens? O gets copied here. Now we come across slash 0, right? So what happens when we do slash 0? S1 of 5 is equal to S2 of 5, So this was slash 0, right? So S1 of 5 now is equal to slash 0. That means now we are comparing slash 0 is not equal to slash 0, which is false, right? So now the loop exits, right? So you can see the entire string is now copied in the section. And that's it. But if you see here, the assignment is actually done, right? If you see here, when I was doing this, because this was an assignment thing, na? So slash yes. 0 is already copied, but the loop is not processed sir. Further. Fine?
Yes, yes.
Yeah,
yes,
but a good doubt actually. Nice.
Thank you, sir.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
In today's class, we have the happy birthday command, XYZ.
Happy birthday, XYZ. Just let me begin. VS Code, file, open folder. Somehow today's class is actually yesterday's class, June 8, right? Okay, select folder. Happy birthday, 6. 7. Happy birthday to you or string
yeah.
compare? This one.
Yeah. If the size 1 would be 20.
Size 1 would be and, 20.
Yeah, and we want to copy that happy birthday to
copy.
You, the size 1.
Size
will
1.
It extend the array?
Let us see the output. Okay. The string in array x is u. Did we change it? Y to X, just a minute. Z is U. Just a minute, let me see. Happy birthday to you. Let me see what is the string. This is 22. Just let me check for a minute. Happy birthday to you. Okay. Okay, some strange output is coming. See, if you see this particular string, happy birthday to you, right? So let me just do a printf. So happy birthday to you is, okay. Let us just write a code. Printf. Person D size of X is equal to strlen string length X. I hope string length X is working. Yeah. See the size of string X, that is happy birthday to you, is 21 in length. Fine. So as long as I'm keeping this size as 21, the program is working absolutely well. Okay, it's not working. Fine. See, when you see this particular size, happy birthday to you is a string length of 21. And the 22nd character should be slash 0. Fine. So the string length is only giving you the length of the string excluding the slash 0. So the string length is 21. So size 1 needs to be at least 22 in order to work correctly. So let me just put this a slash in here. See, the program is working perfectly here. Fine. See, now what happens when you make this less than 22, even 20 or 21, right? Let us keep it 20 because the doubt was for 20. See, now what happens when I'm having a size 1 of 20, I definitely knew that I cannot copy slash 0 to it, right? See, as a result, there is some random gibberish string that is appearing and the output of the string is wrong. So whenever you are doing size 1, right? So where is size 1 in our case? We are doing str cpy x to y. So whenever we are doing string copy, in a particular case, this does not work. Why? Because the original string length was of 21. 22nd character was slash 0, which was the end of the string. But when I'm copying these 20 characters, I am not encountering slash 0. So the compiler does not know where should I terminate. Since the compiler does not know where to terminate, it either prints a random string. And let us do one thing. Let us try to execute it in an online mode because this is a higher version of the compiler. Okay. See, in this particular case, it is working. And that is the strange behavior of C that you will see every time. Let us keep it to 5 and then just check it. Okay. See, when I'm keeping the size as 5, it is showing me the same output. That is a random string here. Don't see the output as U, but just see this is as a random string. U probably is the last character, I guess. Not sure. But let us see changing the size. And in this case, it is printing. So the correct answer, logically, when you are doing the strcpy function, right, so what will happen, the value of x will be copied to y. So y should have at least the length of x. If not, basically, see, I will just explain you in detail what happens. In Java or Python, this is not allowed at all, right? Because in Java and Python, they are strictly typecased. So they want that when I'm doing a copy function, the size of x should be at least the size of y, right? But in C, as you saw, right, when we are giving a size of 15, even it is doing the correct thing, it should not do the correct thing, right? So if somebody asks you, you can just say that the size of y should be at least to the size of x, or it will return a random output, right? It will not work. And why it will not work? Because the character string should end into a slash 0. And if the size of y is not equal to size of x, we will not encounter slash 0. And the compiler will get confused of what to print, right? So that is the answer. If you have any other doubt, you can ask.
And sir, if in a character array, we don't define the null character at the last, will it automatically define that?
Yeah, if you do not define, it will automatically take at the last. But you know, if you are doing any kind of string operations, like for example, in this case, string copy, right? You actually told the compiler to copy only 6 characters. Then it is your responsibility to add the slash 0. But let's say you are defining here. See, in this case, I am not defining slash 0 at the end. In this particular case, the compiler will automatically do this for you. Even if you are defining a character pointer, let's say my str is equal to hi there. In this case also, the compiler will automatically add a slash 0. So all the predefined strings, it will add a slash 0. String copy, it will add a slash 0. See, in string copy, what happens? The entire string of x is copied to entire string of y, right? So x already has a slash 0. So including slash 0, it gets copied. But when you do string ncpy, that is the issue with the case, right? Then you need to add a slash 0 to indicate the end of the string. Fine?
Okay. Yes.
So predefined string, no need to add slash 0. If you are doing some custom operation, add a slash 0 yourself. String compare is done. This is str. So these are again some standard functions which are rarely used, but just for the sake of completeness. Class, just remind me, because you know some students are facing issues in the lab. So I just got from GitHub, Let Us See Solutions, right? So Let Us See is a book by Yashwant Kanetkar. The PDF is already there in our Dropbox. So behind every chapters, there are some unsolved problems of Yashwant Kanetkar, right? So I will be sharing with you the solutions. I just got some link. I just need to verify whether it's a working or not. It may so happen that you may get 90% of the solutions, but my suggestions would be, you know, to try that program before the lab so that you can just get an idea about, you know, how the implementation is done. The issue with any programming language is like we normally teach syntax and all these things. When you do practical lab programs, you know, it gets a bit trickier to think the logic and implement. So after the class, just WhatsApp me on the group. I will just share you in a while. Okay, so we have a strchr, right? Strchr is character. This function returns a pointer to the first occurrence of characters C in the string S. So just let us see this thing. We have a source string, which is known as this is a test. And then we are searching for a character A and Z. Basically, what this does is like, if we want to check whether this particular character is there in this particular string or not, right? So we use this particular function, which is known as strchr, right? So see this strchr. So what I'm doing, this is a string and this is the character. So what was character one? Character one was A. So we are searching whether character A is present in string. So let us see the output for this. So see, the output is A was found in, this is a test. So that means, see, string was, this is a test. We already know that A is present here. So that means this won't return null. This will return the address of the character A, right? So basically, and now second string is Z. So obviously Z is not there. So it will parse the entire string and return null because Z was not found. So usually I have rarely seen the usage of this function because see, if you want to compare a single character, you can directly compare using equal to operator, right? So that is enough, but just sometimes in some implementation, you will see this strchr, right? Again, string length, we already saw as the name specifies what is the length of the string, right? Str, len, len is for length, length. So A, B, C, D up to Z, of course, is 26 alphabets. Then 4 is 4, Boston is 6. Right? String length is very widely used, right? So at times you want to do string copy or all those things using a simple for loop, right? So you can do a string length and then run the loop for that many number of times. Or you can, of course, do till slash 0. That is the best method, actually. And then we also have a memcopy function. So memcopy is almost like a string copy only, right? So just let me execute the code. We have a character string S1, which is 17, and S2, which is like copy this string, fine. And in the memcopy, what is happening? See, S1 to S2. So what will happen? S2 will be get copied to S1. So let us take the board. Guys, somehow the board is not working. Okay, anyways, the last program for the day. So what happens here, S2 gets copied to S1 and only the 5 characters will be copied. So copy and the space character. We have the 5 characters here. So when we run the copy command, you can see this copy is done here. And S1 contains, so basically we have a space here. Hence this space is coming here, fine. So that is all. So memcopy also is rarely used. Str, this is same as almost strncpy. So this will also give you the same output, right? So that's it for today. These are just string functions that we have taken today. And for the next class, we need to do this. Okay, we are running behind one class because of the power failure. Okay, so in the next class, we will actually see this malloc, calloc, and all these things, right? So you can actually just try to execute these codes. These are very simple codes. Malloc is basically memory allocation, fine. So I just give you a brief example. Why do we need memory allocation? See, when we studied arrays, the issue was that, for example, if you define an array age 100, that means you want to take the age of 100 students. It may be possible that you may insert only 12 students, right? So the rest of the 88 goes waste. And at some point you may realize, oh, I had actually 120 students in my class and now what to do, right? So for that particular case, we use malloc, calloc, and realloc is also there. So malloc and all are basically dynamic memory allocation. So this we will see tomorrow because it's a new concept, although it's easy. And all of the dangling pointers, void pointers, null pointers, and while pointers will be covered in tomorrow's class, right? So yeah, regarding the quiz for yesterday, see, Google does not allow for negative marking, right? So we have wrote our own script to compute the score with negative. So I will send you probably today or tomorrow the quiz marks. Everyone will get a CSV file with their correct answer and the wrong answer. So probably till tomorrow. So I think that's it for today. So I think we can, we are done with the class. So any doubts or else we can stop for today.
So in string 9, can you go
up? String 9, just a minute. File, open folder, June 8. String 9, yes.
So in this third last line, if you put 8 instead of 7, it still puts, still gives the answer as minus 3. No, 6.
Okay, can you please repeat it once again?
In second last line, if we put 8 instead of 7, it gives 6 as the output. So why doesn't it compare C and O instead of N and L?
Okay, so you are talking about STRNCMP, right?
Yes.
Okay. So in STR and S1 and S3 or S3 or S1?
S1 and S3.
Okay. S1 and S3. Right. And you are saying why it is giving 6 and not minus 6.
In next line, like where you highlighted the next string.
Okay, you can tell me the line number 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21.
This line number 21.
Okay, line number 21. Okay, so we are comparing S1 and S3. S1 and S3 we are comparing, and we are comparing only the first 7 characters.
Yeah, if we compare the first 8 characters, then why doesn't it compare, why doesn't it give the ASCII difference of E and O?
I got it. Yeah. See, whenever you are doing a string comparison, the objective is basically either to tell whether the strings are equal or not equal, right? So the moment it gets the first difference, it does not even traverse the entire string. The very first difference that it encounters, then it stops basically the process. Get the point? So the moment it sees N and H, for it, the string comparison is done. It does not even go and process these particular string. Even if I, let's say, write here 100 and 100, right? And let us say the string was like this. Let's say A, Z, 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 right? And this string was, let's say this was the case, right? S1 and S3. Everything is equal here except for the first character. So the moment even I say, okay, compare the first 100 bytes, the moment it sees A and B as different, it will do A minus B. So that will be minus 1 in the ASCII. And then it will just return minus 1 and it will not even process any of these strings. Right? So that is the reason it did not compare when you said it did not compare E and O. It did not compare W and L. Right? Also in C, you remember one thing. So let's say when you are writing a if loop, right? Let's say, and you are comparing multiple condition. Let's say this is condition 1. You say or condition 2 or condition 3 or condition 4. So what happens here? So let's say everything is OR, right? A or B or C or D. And you know that in OR, if any one of them is true, the entire loop is true. So what does a compiler do is like, in condition 1, it will check whether this is true or not true. If this is true, right? The compiler will not even try to execute or try to check whether these all are true or not true, right? So let's say if this is false, then only it will go to the second condition. Now let's say this is true. So it will not even try to come to this particular part because it knows that anyway there is no use of checking. Now exactly opposite happens in the case of AND. So let's say now if I keep this as AND, right? The moment the compiler sees that this is false, it will not even execute all the part, even though all of them are true, because they know that for the AND condition to execute, all of the things should be true. Same case happens here. When you are doing string comparison, it just sees the first difference and does not process the rest of the logic. And it makes sense also. Let's say you have a paragraph of 10,000 words each, and you want to compare whether both the paragraphs are identical in nature or not. So the moment you see that the third word of the paragraph is different, you need not compare the rest of the roughly 9,997 words, right? So that is the logic. Yeah.
Sir.
Yes.
In today's last program in memcpy, we did not need to write null character at the end of S1.
Yeah, good question. So let me just check. Probably I will have to check the to the area destination. Technically we should have written it, but let me just check the 5 characters in S2. And the output also appeared correctly. Okay, I will just get back to this, because you know the C library function memcpy copies n characters from memory area source to the memory area destination. I think the issue will be the same thing, that because we have copied only see, the size of S1 was 17, right? And size of S2 is again this. Okay, how much? Okay, let me get back to you with this. I will just confirm it, because I'm not very sure right now about the /0. I will get back to you. You just WhatsApp me once again. I will get back to you in tomorrow's class. Right?
Okay, sir.
Okay. Okay, class, so I'm stopping the share. So you all can leave.